Welcome back to Living Local. Thanks so much for watching the show today. The way we consume media and get our entertainment has changed drastically, even just over the last decade. And that shift has us relying more on the internet. And today we're covering the basics of streaming TV with Metronet. And so here today to talk about this shift and really just how things are changing altogether, but covering streaming specifically, is Eric Vinke, the Iowa manager with Metronet. So thanks for being with us today.
Yes, thanks for having me.
Yes, of course. So can you first kind of just tell us about Metronet? I know it's a bit different than maybe the internet services that we have heard of in the past before.
Sure. So we are 100% fiber internet, high-speed internet. So we say fiber to the home. A lot of technology that you heard about before is called, you know, coax cable or copper wire. Mm-hmm. So our technology is composed of a strand that has tiny pieces of thin glass, like thinner than a strand of hair, and light signals bounce off that glass and can carry speeds up to 1 gigabyte per second. So extremely, extremely fast speeds that are symmetrical, so the same download and upload speed. So if you are at a gig per second download, you're also at a gig per second upload. So it can carry large amounts of data very quickly for multiple devices, whether that is for residential or business services.
Okay, that's wonderful. And I know that people have probably seen your trucks all around the Quad Cities. It's a special way that you all install this too. Can you break that down for us?
Sure. So what we do is, obviously we have our infrastructure that we have to place throughout the city. Mm-hmm. That happens first. And once that infrastructure is in place and all of our testing is done with that process and we are ready to serve homes and businesses, our team of residential installers or business installers then come out, they do a quick survey visually of the property of where they can bring that connection from. Mm-hmm. And then they will also, there is some flexibility there on depending on where we might be able to bring it in the house at. And they will place a box, a small box on the outside of the house, mm-hmm. run that fiber inside, and then bring that connectivity throughout your house.
Okay, sounds good. I followed all of that, I promise. Makes total sense. And so I want us to obviously talk about streaming today. Streaming has really gained popularity over just the past few years, but also even before that too. But now I feel like almost everyone is doing some sort of streaming. Can you talk about what that is for those who maybe don't have any experience with streaming just yet?
Sure. So a lot of people are used to, or most people might be used to, television coming through cable or satellite. So streaming is when that television signal, and it's whether it's live TV, it can also be pre-recorded shows and segments, mm-hmm. comes through your internet connection. So there is no need for a cable box or things like that. You use your device that is connected to the internet. That could be a smart TV, a streaming device such as a Roku stick or an Amazon Fire stick or a tablet or phone. And with that internet connection, that feed and that signal of that television show or service comes through onto your device.
Okay, yeah. So you're using the internet to get that entertainment then.
Right. And you can do that for live TV. A lot of, you know, I think people might be used to things like Netflix, Amazon Prime, where those are pre-recorded. Mm-hmm. Obviously, that's also streaming, but now you have the ability to stream live TV through things like Hulu Live, YouTube, Sling TV. Mm-hmm. So you can get the best of both worlds. You can get your live television, and then you can also get those shows that you might become accustomed to that you like that are pre-recorded or TV series.
Okay, and that is really touching on what we keep hearing about cutting the cord then, so really cutting those traditional cable services.
Right, so you can absolutely use your internet then as your provider for television. So rather than having an internet connection and maybe a television connection, you use that internet and that speed and capacity that we talked about, mm-hmm. in order to have your TV content streamed to you. Okay. You can do that across multiple devices in your house, so someone could be watching a show in the bedroom while somebody in the living room is watching something different. So it's not, you know, it's very flexible, just as what you would used to when it comes to standard TV, with some added benefits.
Yeah, a little more personalized, honestly, and a little more customized to what the family wants, the viewer wants, all of those things.
Yeah, so a lot of streaming services get to know the type of shows you tend to gravitate, mm-hmm. towards and what you like and what you don't. They'll provide recommendations. Hulu TV or Live is one of those that will let you choose your favorite teams, your favorite topics, maybe you like history, things like that, and then it'll curtail your suggestions to that, or to let you know that the Chicago Cubs are playing today. Do you, mm-hmm. want to turn that game on? So it gives you a more personalized experience. You can also have separate profiles. So just because I like certain topics, my wife might like things that are different.
Yeah.
And so when she signs onto that device, it'll give her recommendations And when I sign on, it'll give my recommendations.
Okay, yep, that sounds good. And I can relate to this too. Whenever I turn on my Netflix, it'll say, oh, do you want to try this one
right.
out? You want to try that? I watch a lot of crime documentaries, so that's usually what is coming up on my feed. And how would you say that you all, your service really, is supporting those here in the Quad Cities that are streaming?
Absolutely. It goes back to that speed and capacity because of the fact that we provide speeds that are symmetrical upload and download.
Mm-hmm.
We can keep up with that demand, whether it's a single device or multiple devices, large families, single family homes. But it provides you that you don't get the buffering. You don't see things like waiting to load and content waiting to load because video does take a larger amount of bandwidth. It takes more to view video than it does to listen to music or to browse the internet itself. And with those speeds that we offer that are up to a gigabyte, it helps support that. So you can have multiple simultaneous devices streaming, or if you've got a lot of smart home products,
mm-hmm.
Laptops, tablets, anything like that, it supports multiple devices throughout your entire house.
Yeah, and that's extremely important when you have kids and teens and adults all together in the
yes.
home, and everybody has a device now. It's rare when you don't see somebody that has a phone or a tablet or a laptop.
Right, absolutely.
Yeah.
A lot of, even phones, during the pandemic, there was a lot of work from home.
Yes.
Those phones ran over internet, signals and things like that. So it can support all of the, your Zoom meetings, we call it a soft phone. So if your phone's connected through the internet, things of that nature, all at the same time while your kids may be in the other room watching their shows on their tablets or on the TV.
You're playing some sort of video game,
right,
of course.
Exactly.
Yes. All right. Well, thank you so much for breaking this down. And I really hope that our viewers are able to benefit from this information.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. All right. And so if you want to learn more about MetroNet, you can go to metronetinc.com/getfibernow. And we'll also have those details posted on our website over at ourquadcities.com.